As many things are wreaking havoc on the UK today, some British industries have stalled. One such industry is car manufacturing, thanks to the decline of diesel and a high barrier to entry with regards to electric vehicles, which are dominated by a few key players. But with a push towards new cars being made electric to reduce harmful emissions, Arrival, a UK startup, has decided to embrace the challenge, albeit with a focus on commercial vehicles. Introducing buses and vans that few have seen before, the goal is to create a less harmful and greater human experience whenever you or one of your parcels travels. But what is Arrival? Why have they succeeded in the electronic vehicle market? And how have they not only designed a game-changing vehicle range, but also a new way to operate a car manufacturing business? Here's how it happened. Arrival, the firm founded by Russian Denis Sverdlov, is a company based in London with a mission to make electric vehicles, primarily commercial ones such as vans and buses, that are able to deliver an experience like no other, but are priced the same as their fossil fuel equivalents. Their technology and electricity-oriented vehicle range will be designed with everyone who interacts with the vehicle in mind, from drivers to passengers, fleet operators, and even cleaners. The goal is to provide worldwide transport that is sustainable in an era where commercial vehicles are more popular than ever, thanks to online shopping. Headquartered in London, but with R&D facilities and office locations across Europe and the Americas, the company is already geared up for rapid worldwide expansion, despite being just 5 years old. With the company determined to create the most advanced vehicles that will redefine industry standards by way of connectivity and intelligence, let's dive into why Arrival has succeeded where others haven't. For starters, they're looking to combat traditional combustion engines head-on, pricing the electric vehicle at the same level, in what they call Generation 2.0. They've also embraced technology to enhance the customer experience both inside and out. Numerous screens on the inside will be used to show the route in more detail and provide information about local attractions. Whilst on the outside, there's a large wraparound screen that could be used for a number of reasons, such as which door would be best for entering the bus, depending on how full it is. The driver will even have his own Tesla-style screen that will replace the fiddly buttons, and, as with everything nowadays, they'll be exclusively cashless. The buses will also be more connected than ever, meaning that fleet managers can deploy more buses or vans depending on how much demand there is. The chief experience officer, Kwame Nyanying, thinks that a lot of other bus manufacturers are just making buses. They're not making systems, and that's the thing that distinguishes us. And finally, the onboard experience is to be more positive and uplifting, with a skylight running the length of the bus, as well as calming music that will play throughout the cabin. The interior can then be shifted to have flexible seating configurations, again, depending on demand, which also makes it easier for cleaners to come in and clean, which in turn improves the experience at a time where staying healthy is more important than ever. Arrival, being the tech disruptor they are, have decided to avoid traditional mega factories, but rather building micro factories to build their electric vehicles. These micro factories will be able to build the full vehicles with robots to limit costs and improve efficiency. They'll also be smaller so that they can be located closer to metropolitan areas to save on delivery times and adjust the supply with demand, with the goal of building 1,000 microfactories globally by 2026, regenerating local communities, and perhaps controversially, paying local taxes. Their current factory is based in Banbury, in Oxfordshire, and the next one is already being built near Bicester to meet the continual demands of the area. The aim is to be able to manufacture on demand and deliver in 3 months. And despite their vehicles only being able to travel just over 100 miles before needing a recharge, most of them will be used in urban areas, delivering by day and charging by night. Even the manufacturing process is different. They'll use a skateboard style of vehicle, where the wheels are connected to a flat body, allowing the vans and buses to be built by robots and making them modular by nature, meaning broken parts can be swapped out or upgraded as technology improves. All whilst reducing air pollution, targeting the cities that are delivering and receiving the most packages, with the likes of New York and London receiving over 1 million packages a day. Whilst it's not yet legal, all the vans will come with autonomous driving capabilities. And whilst they can't be used on the open road just yet, they can be used in private locations, such as a depot. something like a depot could be fully automated, making the vehicle manufacturer part of the technological revolution. Despite being founded just 5 years ago, Arrival has already generated numerous strategic partnerships to uncover where demand lies and who might be interested. In 2017, Royal Mail trialled 9 vehicles through London, and in 2019, UPS announced a deal to trial 35 vehicles across London and Paris. UPS loved it so much that in January 2020, they invested heavily in Arrival, placing an order for 10,000 electric vehicles to be rolled out in the UK, Europe, and the USA, reportedly worth $400 million and a stake in the business. That values each vehicle at around £34,000 a pop, in line with their gas-guzzling counterparts. And speaking of valuations, Arrival became a unicorn company in 2020 after Hyundai and Kia Motors invested 100 million euros, valuing the company at 3 billion euros. But what does the future hold? Well, the company has been announced in LinkedIn's top startups 2 years in a row, and with taxis, delivery robots, charging infrastructure, and digital services on the horizon, it's not really much of a surprise. The concern is that the industry is crowded already, albeit in its infancy, with the BYD Chinese buses, Proterra's American version, Rivian's SUVs and the delivery van, with Amazon placing an order for 100,000 units, Muji's Japanese autonomous shuttle buses, Gacha, or the Swedish Einride's logging truck that drives itself. And we haven't even mentioned Tesla yet. But as far as Arrival are concerned, other companies are just making buses, whereas Arrival are making systems and establishing themselves amongst the revolution for a cleaner future. The game changer is that until this point, all electric vehicles have been more expensive. And if you can remove that barrier, the market will explode. Thanks for watching.